Show you how we do the long one. So I take my chair and I'll put it close to here. Libby, Libby, Libby. And I'll put on my favorite TV program. I'm gonna have to get you a different bag.
It starts when she gets up.
Yep.
So this could be like a 3-hour thing.
No. She'll give up way before then. I'm just doing it for a few minutes right now that my hand will leash off to you. Now I usually just have to get up like 3 times, so it's like.
And we stay for, is that a half hour?
Oh, 15 minutes at a time? But you can just do it 5 minutes at a time. You can build up to 15 minutes. You can build up to a half an hour. I do all my adult dogs. Well, my Shana can do a good hour in her place. You know, if I'm busy doing something else. I want to make sure she doesn't, you know, get into trouble.
I know, ideally I would like for her to not sit in her crate. I want her to like it if she needs to be in one.
Right.
I don't want her to sleep in a crate like all the time.
Yeah.
I would like her to just exist in the house, but we're definitely not there yet.
Takes time. How old is she now?
She was 8 weeks when I got her, and that was in March 8th. So I think she's a 4.5 months old.
Yeah. She's a lot more mature than a 4.5 month old.
You think so?
Yeah.
She's like this big when I got her. She's tiny. She's like quadrupled in size.
Yeah.
I don't know. I think she's gonna be huge.
No. I think she's
picture at least, but 8 years.
She's also a very pretty, sweet girl.
I'm just curious because her paws still look disproportionately huge.
Yeah.
But her head's so tiny.
Yep. This is what she was doing when we did it. We're doing our 15 minutes. She fell fast asleep.
She really is a good dog. She's so cute.
Technically, all dogs are usually good dogs. She's a very kind of stably temperamented.
Yeah. All dogs are good dogs. People are just bad owners. Most of the time. I did not want a puppy.
She's a good puppy though.
Yeah, I don't know if I told you, we went looking for an older dog.
Yeah.
And there was one there, big pit bull, big blocky face, yeah. Big dopey guy, so sweet, loves Sawyer. And like,
where did you get her from? Alpha Dogs by any chance?
No, the animal officially.
Yeah.
So we went in just to meet. This dog's name is Levi, so
yeah.
We just went in to meet him.
Yeah.
And I fell in love with him, and then Elise said, oh, just let me know. He has severe dog aggression.
Oh boy.
And I was like,
no, not good with a kid.
Well, she said that he'd be fine. He's fine with people.
Right.
And ironically, fine with cats.
Right, but imagine you're taking a walk now
right.
With your
and that's
child.
And that's a deal breaker for me. Because I guess he like completely just like almost ripped apart a dog. And it's like, they said it was in a severe case of dog aggression.
Yeah.
I was like, I can't, if it was just me.
Right, exactly.
I wouldn't care.
Like me and my husband, we don't have any kids. And so we do have dogs. We do have to put them into the equation.
Right. I mean, my uncle's the same way. Him and his wife have always had dogs.
Yeah.
Like golden retrievers.
Yeah.
Two of them at a time.
Yeah.
My whole life. So I definitely get that. But I was so heartbroken. I was like, oh my God, I really just like fell in love with this
yeah.
dog and I just can't take him home because it's not
yeah.
the right fit.
But that was a good decision.
Right. I mean,
so many people would discount that, bring the dog home and then find out that the dog was too much for them or something would happen.
Right. And like everything except for this one part of his personality,
yeah.
absolutely perfect.
Yeah.
Did not show one ounce of aggression towards people or
yeah.
children or anything, which was like my biggest thing.
Yeah.
He was house trained,
yeah.
you know, but he just couldn't do other dogs, and I can't hold myself accountable
right.
if I'm held accountable for my son.
It's a lot harder to deal to train a dog aggressive dog than it is a puppy.
Right.
Trust me.
Yeah. So then she was just like, "Oh, yeah, we're home," and I was like, "Okay." And then she brought in Libby, and I was like, fuck you. Now I have to take her home. She's so cute. This is exactly what I didn't want. But we fell in love with her, like, instantaneously. Like, Sawyer just loved her.
And so me and my husband always warn ourselves, if we go to see a dog, we're probably coming home with a dog. So let's,
right.
let's, yeah, whether we're going to go see the dog or not.
Right.
Chances are.
I know, and it was funny, too, because when we walked in, I guess they just put them, there's her and her sister.
Yeah.
And we were in the lobby waiting for somebody to bring us in.
Yeah.
And this older woman, she must have been in like her late 60s, early 70s, took her sister home.
Yeah.
So Sawyer was petting her.
Yeah.
And I was like, excuse me, puppy, whatever.
Yeah.
We're here for another dog. And I guess they just put them online like after Sawyer and I got there.
Yeah.
So we were the first people to meet Libby.
Yeah.
Her name's Christina. And I noticed, who must have gotten like a heads up or something.
Yeah.
And then all of a sudden, all these people were walking by the room, like looking in.
Oh no.
Because they saw the puppies were posted online, and they flocked to the shelter. Yeah. So we just got there at the perfect time, and I'm like, it's meant to be. Gotta get her.
She got lucky.
I think so. Do what we can to make sure that she's well rounded.
And this is what I like them to do in their place. It's not the goal, but it's their safe place. They learn that to relax in it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that's, you know, puppies need to learn how to relax.
And she does. She's really good in her crate.
Yeah.
I'm like, okay, go to bed. And she's like,
yeah.
Go right in there.
Yeah.
She's got like her stuffy and her squeaky and whatever.
Yeah.
She'll just hang out in there.
Yeah.
She has no problems going.
I mean, relax out in the boat even with the other puppies here, which can be very hard for puppies to do. So when we have Bigsby and Bailey and her out, you know, it can be a little hectic all of a sudden, and then you want them to learn to like leave each other alone for a little while, take a nap, you know, go do the place with your friends around you. And Bailey wanted her to play, so she kept coming over with the bone and dropping the bowl and bringing the ball over, you know.
Oh, Libby.
But you really want dogs to learn how to relax around each other. They don't have to do that the whole time. They can have crazy time, but you want them to know how to relax around each other.
Yeah.
Like that. It makes for much more healthy, emotionally healthy dogs.
Mm-hmm.
We're rats around that Mount Sawyer. He's
getting crazy.
Yes.
And that was a big issue, which has actually not been an issue since she started coming here, is that she would start getting really rough with him.
Well, yeah.
Which I was telling Ruben about. And she wasn't doing it like in a malicious way, but then he would end up getting scratched, or she'd end up biting his ear, and you know. And
that's what she does to her puppy friends.
Yes.
Right? Yeah.
Right. And I was like, this is just going to get out of control. So. She actually hasn't really been doing that at all. Like, occasionally she will jump on him, but most of the time she just kind of gets curious and she'll just like hover around him.
Yeah.
As opposed to like pounce on
him.
Which is fine.
Yeah.
And when he's over and he told her to go away, he's like, let me go. Breathe. Let me down. So he tells her. But he's really good with the other dogs too. He doesn't really approach animals. He doesn't know just the teach him really young.
Did you get a laser?
Okay, Libby.
I'm sleeping here now.
Good girl. Good girl.
So that was about it this week.
About healing, a lot of sitting, a lot of sleeping.
Yeah. Stays. Don't forget the sitters.
Sitters. Yes. And sisters. What do you think? Do you want to go home?
Jesus, I'm a good girl.
Do you want to go home and sleep in your own bed? I'm going to have to get you a new place spot. I'm going to have to get a milk crate from work or something.
Well, you can just do it on a bed. Or a full little blanket, if it's thick enough. I like a milk crate because it does tend to have edges that keeps them in. You know, and I can put a blanket in there too, and it just works well for a dog bed. And she usually goes in there to take a nap when she's done with one of her friends.